Hello students. So students, I have already completed the chapter friction. So today I'll discuss question answers. So short questions and long questions write in your copies, and very short answer type questions you can write in the book. First, name the force. We have already done. I have given you this for homework, but some of the students have written wrong answers, so you can correct it. Name the force which always opposes motion, that is friction. Question number two, why does a fast car slow down if its engine is switched off? Because of the frictional force becomes more than the applied force. Question number three, which type of surfaces produces least friction, that is smooth surface, too much friction, rough surface. Question number four, what is the direction of the force of friction acting on a moving object? It is in the opposite direction in which the object moves. Question number five, name a device which is used to measure force acting on an object, that is spring balance. Question number six, same only. So leave question number six. Question number seven, out of sliding friction, static friction and rolling friction, which one is the smallest? So rolling friction is the smallest. Which one is the largest? Static friction is the largest. Question number eight, which type of friction comes into play when a book kept on a cylindrical pencils is moved by pushing? So that is rolling friction. Question number nine, why is it more difficult to walk properly on a well-polished floor? It is more difficult to walk properly on a well-polished floor because in a well-polished floor, the force of friction is least. Question number 10, why is it difficult to walk on a wet marble floor? So same only, question number 9 and 10 is same. Which force is responsible for wearing out of a car tires? So that is frictional force. Question number 12, which prevents you from slipping every time you take a step forward? Again frictional force. Question number 13, name the force which helps things to move and stop. Again same frictional force. Question number 14, which enables us to fix nails in the wall and knots to be tied, that is again frictional force. Question number 15, what makes the steps of foot over bridges at railway stations to wear out slowly? Force of friction. Question number 16, what is done to increase friction between the tires and a road? To increase the friction, the tires are treaded, TREADED. Okay, so question number 17, why do gymnasts apply a coarse substance to their hands? In the gymnast, they apply a coarse substance to their hands to increase the force of friction between the surface of the hand and the object, to have a better grip of the object. Question number 18, why do kabaddi players rub their hands with dry soil? Just now I have given you the answer, so it is same only question number 17 and 18. Question number 19, name the device which is used between the hubs and axles of bicycle wheels to reduce the friction. So it's ball bearings. Question number 20, what is the purpose of using ball bearings in machine? So the purpose is to reduce the friction. Question number 21 and 23 you will do in homework. Question number 22, name the device which is attached to heavy luggage to move it easily by pulling. So what is that device? Name the device which is attached to a heavy luggage. So what is that heavy device? It is, you can say rollers. Okay. Question number 24, why does oiling the axle of a bicycle makes the bicycle move more freely? Because oiling the axles of a bicycle reduces, you can say it smoothens the axles and reduces the force of friction. So that is why it makes the bicycle move more easily. Question number 25, state one way in which friction between wheel and axle can be reduced. Again, same question is repeated again and again. So you can leave this question number 25. Question number 26, name two common lubricants. So two common lubricants are oil and grease. Question number 27, why do we sprinkle fine powder on carom board? We sprinkle fine powder on carom board to make the surface smooth and to reduce the force of friction. Question number 28, which force gets reduced when the two surfaces in contact are polished? Friction force. Same question is they are asking again and again. So we will not do those questions which are repeated again and again. what is the special name of a frictional force exerted by fluid? So frictional force exerted by fluid is called as drag. So please write drag. What is the name of special shapes which is given to objects moving through air? So that is a streamlined shape. Why are grooves provided in the soles of the shoes? Definitely to reduce friction. Same question number 34 also. Question number 35, you can do fill in the blanks. It's given at the back of the chapter. Question number 36. When we try to push a heavy box kept on the ground, it does not move at all. Which force is preventing this box? Which box is preventing? That is force of friction. Where does this force act? This force acts in the it opposes the motion of the movement of the heavy box. So it is a opposing force. It acts opposite in the direction or the movement of the box. Suppose your writing table is tilted a little, a book kept. Achha, this here you have to draw a drawing. For that, open page number 214. So you can see in page number 214, which I have also explained to you. So you will draw the drawing of this book. Please see page number 214. You can see here. This is, so please draw this diagram, figure 3. Where does this force act? So this force, you can see in the book, it's given, it acts in an opposite direction. Which will cause more friction, a rough surface or a smooth surface? This I have already explained to you, but you can write the answer. Which surface will cause more friction? So rough surface will cause more friction because the irregularities between the rough surface get interlocked more strongly, thereby increasing the force of friction. Explain why sliding friction is less than static friction. Open page 219. So why sliding friction is less? Because you know this thing. So open page 219 here. You can see in page 2 number 19. Please mark from here. Sliding friction is smaller than the static friction. It is easier to keep the object moving which is already in motion than to move the same object from rest. Okay. So what is the question? Sliding friction is less. Okay. So please mark from here till static friction. After that, write when an object has already started moving, the irregularities of the surface do not get enough time to lock into the irregularities on the surface of the other object completely. Since the interlocking of the two surfaces are less when the object has already started moving, therefore the sliding friction is smaller than the static friction. Please mark the answer from here. Okay. You can write when the object has already started moving. Okay, so please mark. What is meant by rolling friction? So you just have to write in definition. Open page number 219. So what is a rolling friction? Where it is written? Here, question number 40. Rolling friction. Open page 219 and mark from here. When an object rolls over the surface of another. Okay, from here, mark till rolling friction. You can see. Sorry students. Now question number 41. Iqbal has to push a lighter box and Seema has to push a similar heavier box on the same floor. Who will have to apply larger force and why? So Seema has to apply larger force. Why has to apply larger force? Because in the heavier box, the irregularities of both the surface of the box and the floor, it gets interlocked strongly. So that is why the force of friction is more and she has to apply more force. Okay. Question number 42. Why does a man slip when he steps on the banana peel thrown on the road? Page 221. Please open page 221. I have already explained you. Please underline, this is because the inner side of the banana peel being smooth and slippery reduces the friction. Okay, please mark till slipping backwards. Car wheels often spin on icy roads. Explain why. Again, page 221. So why does car tires spin on the icy roads? Because you know, our surface of the ice is smooth. So if the surface of the ice is smooth, then what will happen? The friction will be less. So what happens? The forward drag, forward force, frictional force is not applied there, and the car does not move forward. Whereas the wheels remains there, and instead of moving, it spins. So you can mark the answer from here. If there, 1 minute. Yes, you can write this answer. 2 to 1. So I have already told you here. It spin on the icy roads because the force of friction is very very less. Okay, and because the force of friction is very very less, the wheels of the car spin at the same place, but the car would not move forward at all. Okay, the car would stay where it is. Okay, so that you have to write. Explain why pencil will write on paper but not on glass. Why pencil will write on paper? Pencil, you know, pencil nib is made up of a graphite, which is a carbon. So when we write the with the pencil on the paper, so there is a force of friction between the paper and the pencil, but there is the force of friction between the glass and the pencil is very very zero. So it is due to the force of friction between the pencil and the paper that we can write. Please open for this page number 222. Here you can write. See, we cannot write with a pencil on the glass sheet because the glass surface is very smooth, due to which friction between the tip of the pencil and glass surface is much less. Thus, friction is not sufficient to rub off black graphite particles from the tip of the pencil. You know how we write when we write on the piece of paper. So there is a force of friction between the tip of the pencil and the paper, and because of the friction, the carbon particles on the tip of the pencil gets rubbed off, and it leaves a mark on the paper. Understood? But it does not happen when one writes on the glass, because the force of friction is very very less, and the this thing carbon particles or tip, it does not. See here, not sufficient to. Okay, so here the friction is not sufficient to rub off the black graphite particles, but whereas with case in case of paper and pencil, the force of friction is more, which can rub off the carbon particles. This one you can write. Okay, where climbing the greasy pole is difficult. Yes, climbing a greasy pole is difficult because again the force of friction is very very less. So that is why if the force of friction is very very less, then the person may fall down. Okay, question number 45. Why does a matchstick light when we strike it on a rough surface? When we strike a matchstick on a rough surface, you can see here what happens when we strike a matchstick on the rough surface. So there is the force of friction between the surface of the matchstick and the matchstick tip of the matchstick is more. So what happens so it produces heat, and this heat burns the chemical of the matchstick. Okay, so that is why the matchstick can be burned. See here, a matchstick can be lighted up. Why? You can, if you want, you can write the answer from the book also, and you can write in your own words also. Page number 40, sorry, page number 222. So see, friction enables us to light the matchstick. You can write the answer from here. When we rub a matchstick, till lights up. Okay, but please try to write the answers in your own words, all of you. Which parts wear away first in shoes? Soles. Give reason for the answer. Page number 223. Please open page number 223 for question number 47. You can write from here. When the soles of our shoes rub against the rough surface of the road, what happens? The force of friction, it what happens? You can write here. Soles of the shoes rub against the rough surface of the road, then the tiny pieces of the soles keep on breaking off. Okay, because of the friction, the soles, it keeps on, the pieces of the soles keep on breaking off. Okay, and due to which the soles of our shoes wear out gradually, and the wear and tear of soles of our shoes ultimately causes holes in the soles. So please write from here. page 100 to 123, and the soles of our shoes. Okay, please write. A pencil eraser. What happens when you rub your hands vigorously? So question number 50. What happens when we rub our hands? When we rub our hands, the heat is produced. So that one you can write. Question number 51. How a friction enables us to walk without slipping? Open page 100 to 120. Open page 220. Page 200. Friction enables. Okay, please open page 220. Please underline. From here, we are able to walk because friction, because of the friction between the sole of our shoes and the ground. Okay, please. Okay. So please underline this full paragraph and try to write in your own words. I have already discussed all these things with you. Which is easier to hold in hand, a cooler or a glass tumbler? Definitely cooler. Why? Because it has a smooth surface, so the friction is more. Here you can write. Please underline. It is easier to hold a cooler in a hand than a glass tumbler. Please underline or from here till hands. Explain why the question number 54, why the soles of our shoes wear out gradually. This we have done. Why do tires of the cars wear out gradually? This also number of times we have done. Okay, so this one you can leave for some. I have already discussed with you. State two advantages and two disadvantages of friction. This one, advantages of friction, we are able to ride, we are able to walk. What are the disadvantages? Wear and tear of soles, machine parts. Okay, explain why sportsmen use shoes with spikes. Page 225, open page 225. So why the sportsmen wear the shoes with spikes? You can write from here. Spikes are pointed nails from here till athlete on running. Okay, so please mark till here. How will you reduce friction between those machine parts which rub against each other? Give the simplest method. How you will reduce friction? We can reduce friction. How you can reduce friction between those machine parts which rub against each other? By applying lubricants, grease. Okay, second is by using ball bearings. Explain with the help of a diagram how the use of oil reduces friction. For that, open page 226. So please underline, please you can draw this diagram given on point number 2. Why are cars, aeroplanes and rockets streamlined? To reduce frictional force or to reduce drag? Why a speedboat has a streamlined shape? Again, to reduce friction force. What are fluids? That you know, fluids. Please underline, open page 228. Those substances which are able to flow, easily are called fluids. So you can write water and air are the two fluids. Define friction. What are the factors affecting the friction? Please open page 213. What is the friction? You can write from page number 213. Please write from here. The force which always opposes the motion till friction. What are the factors affecting friction? So what are the factors? So please underline. The factors affecting friction are nature. These two. Nature of the two surfaces, the force. Okay, so that you have to write. Give examples to show that friction depends on nature of the two surfaces. So you can write an activity which is given on page 216. Here, this activity you can write. Okay. Give example to show that friction depends on the force. Here also you can write activity 2.11. Open page 217, and you can write this activity for question number 67 B part. Okay, What is the difference between the static and the sliding friction? Simply write the this one you can write in a tabulated form. Make a line in the center. One side write static friction. One side write sliding friction. So in static friction you can write the maximum frictional force till static friction, and sliding friction you can write the frictional force till sliding friction. That is enough. What is given? What is the difference for the given pair? Which of the two is greater? So static friction is greater. How can a very heavy machine be moved conveniently from one place to another in a factory? No crane is available. Definitely by on the rollers. Open page 220. You can see it's given on page 220. Here you can see heavy machines can be easily moved from one place to another by placing round logs of wood under them and pushing. Okay, so you write the answer from here to here and draw the diagram also. What is drag? The frictional force of fluids is called as drag. Give two examples of a drag force. See here, I have already told you, na, drag. Here the frictional force exerted by fluids is called as drag. Typical examples you can write from here till here, till C. How can you reduce the drag on something moving through air? By giving the streamline shape. What is meant by streamline shape? Name the object which usually has a streamline shape. Streamline shape, the objects which have a streamline shape are bird, aeroplanes. Why? What is a streamline shape? The shape which offers minimum resistance to the drag. Explain why objects moving in fluids something have a same question they are asking again and again. The last answer to last question is also to reduce force of friction or to reduce drag. Okay, multiple choice questions you can write do from the exercise. So I have completed question answers also of friction chapter. In the next class I will start with metals and non-metals, and mainly we will discuss physical properties or one or two more properties of metal. One physical properties we will discuss and one or two important chemical properties of metals and non-metals. Okay students, thank you. Have a nice day.